Hello, everybody. Andrea Majeski here with Dental Elm. So the holidays are fast approaching, which also means that a lot of dental hygienists have to get in their portfolios to be audited. So you do have until January 31st. The CDHO starts accepting the portfolios now come January 1st. So even if you want to send it in sooner, I think you can, but they don't actually start reading them until January the 1st. So if you need help with this, let me know, because I do offer a portfolio review package, meaning that I will actually log into your portfolio. You would give me a temporary password, a temporary sign-in, and I go through everything. So all of your goals, your learning activities, everything. So it does take me time, but I like to go through everything to let you know what I might feel you might want to change. I've been finding that a lot of the goals aren't specific enough, so I do tell people to kind of change the wording a little bit. Now, I don't work for the CDHO, so I can't give you a 100% guarantee that if I look at it, you will pass your audit. But so far, I have been successful in doing that. So it does help people know if you're on the right track or if you're not on the right track at all. I've seen a little bit of both, where I have looked at portfolios that I think are perfect, that I would actually not change a thing, and that never happens. I've looked at a lot of portfolios where the goals need to be more specific or the learning activities just simply aren't enough. I've looked at portfolios where they don't even have the full 75 hours in over the 3 years. And that's the most important. If you do not have 75 hours or more over those 3 years, they will not accept it. You will have to do it again. And that's pretty easy, right? Like, you don't want them calling you. You don't want them sending you a letter. It just makes sense to get all of that stuff in and make sure to do your self-assessment for 2019 also. But I do help you with that if you need help. If you would like me to review your portfolio, the turnaround time now, because it's the holidays, is about 2 weeks, because that's when everybody seems to be giving me their portfolios to look at. It does take me several hours to look at each one, but it does help, because I don't actually change anything inside your portfolio. What I do, in fact, I can share my screen for a second here. So I was just working on, I'm just going to make sure that I took the name out of this person. Oh, actually, sorry. The name is still there. Hold on. I wanted to kind of show you guys an example here. I just want to change the file name, because the file name is the person's name. So sorry, one moment. I'm just going to give it a different file name here. So I'm going to share my screen. I was working on this earlier this morning, just so I can give you guys an example of what it kind of looks like. So here we go. So all I do is I log in and I go through every single goal that you have, every single learning activity that you have, and I make notes. So I just started doing this one here. I let you know if I love it or if I think we could improve things a little bit more. If I feel your goal isn't wordy enough, then I do offer kind of ideas on how to change things. Or there has been some instances where I don't think a goal is good at all, and I might suggest coming up with an entirely new one. Or sometimes goals sound almost the same, but they're separate. So I might advise to kind of put them all together into one. So I do look through everything. And I send you a sheet that kind of looks like this, where I put your year down. I put down every single goal that you do have, and I put points underneath. Now, as I said, I don't actually change anything, but I give you, I guess, guidelines on what I feel you could change. Things that I don't think I had highlighted anything in red here, but if I do highlight something in red, that means that I do strongly advise you to change it, because I'm pretty sure that it will not be accepted. I've reviewed probably over 100 portfolios at this point. So I do kind of have an idea of what they like and what they don't like. I submitted my portfolio. It's been a while though. I think it's been about 4 years or so. So I do have an idea of what the CDHO is looking for. And I think it just helps you too, to have an idea of if you're on the right track, if you're not on the right track at all. Cause I have seen a couple where their portfolio just, you know, I apologize to say, but it's just not up to par and they need to kind of redo the whole thing. Now that doesn't happen often. I think it's happened once, but it does happen. So if you guys need help, let me know. Here, I'm just going to stop sharing my screen. I'll leave the link for you to sign up on the bottom because they do take me several hours to look through everything, because I do. I look through everything. There's about a 2-week turnaround time at the moment with the holidays. So if you want me to look at yours, now is the time. And if you aren't actually doing your portfolio, then I do offer a study group as well online for the quality assurance test. So if you need help with that, the quality assurance test, so instead of the portfolio, was changed in October. So I did have to update my entire course, but it looks awesome. And so far, it does have a 100% success rate for those who have taken my course, have passed the quality assurance exam. So that's everybody. So I know that I can help you if it's either the portfolio that you need help with or the quality assurance exam. So I'll leave both links for you on the bottom. And if you guys have any questions, just let me know. I am so happy to help. And I will see you guys in the next one.